There you go. All right. Well, we want to welcome you to our old-fashioned Christmas. You know, it seems like Christmas time is a wonderful time to get together. We remember from our childhood days, that was a time when family gathered, when the house was decorated, when we were looking forward to surprises that were coming. So we really wanted to do a special event for you in town to remember the old-fashioned Christmas. So be sure and notice the whether it's the bubble lights in the kitchen or all the different activities from different times and places, the silver trees from the 50s or the white trees from the 60s. Just kind of enjoy some of the things that we have for you, as well as featuring some of the wonderful antiques that we have, the phonographs and the pump organ. So I'm just going to start with just a little reading of what is an old-fashioned Christmas. "What is an old-fashioned Christmas?" a boy asked his parents one day. They thought for a while before they would venture to say. And after talking it through and pondering a while, they tried to portray to him the old-fashioned style. You see, the holiday season we all know of today often seems a far cry from what this season should portray. People crowd in the stores buying meaningless gifts and toys. It's far too large a quantity for all the girls and boys. In the old-fashioned Christmas, things were different, you see. Far fewer gifts than there seemed to be. So they were all given with love beyond measure, making the giving a wonderful treasure. In the old-fashioned Christmas, the best gifts of all were those of goodwill, or perhaps a token, very small. Toys were not given in excess by the score, and many gifts were homemade, not bought from the store. So in an old-fashioned Christmas you wish now to see, remember the quantity of gifts is immaterial as can be. For an old-fashioned Christmas, let's all start now by remembering a friend that begins in the heart. Through the giving of kindness and goodwill to all mankind, an old-fashioned Christmas we certainly can find. The gifts with a meaning in this season play a part with an old-fashioned Christmas that begins in the heart. You probably remember at Christmas time it was a lot of special things. Maybe it was a new dress that you got, or something that's special for Christmas programs at church or school. Today we're going to have one of those pieces from Tammy Mount, who is going to play her saxophone. And remember, just you can think back to times when maybe you performed in a program or memorized a piece or got dressed up for a special event at your church. So Tammy, take it away.
I don't memorize like I used to in high school. You need notes in front of me.
Thank you.
or for school. Anybody want to share that story, or maybe a special gift that you can remember from your childhood that was very meaningful to you? Anybody have an idea that you remember from 70 or so years ago?
I remember once that we knew that Mom and Dad had hid our gifts behind the headboard of their bed, and they were gone. And we looked, and it was so disappointing because there was no surprise on Christmas morning.
That's the box. People who shake boxes too have that same. Anybody else want to share?
Well, one of the things that I remember is my brother Jim was sick at Christmas time. And we usually didn't have much of a tree, but Mom bought bubble lights, especially for him.
Oh.
You know, and we put them on our tree, you know, the rest of the, and I think maybe Marcia has them, I'm not sure. But that was our Christmas, and the carolers came, and mm-hmm. we were all probably pretty much ready for bed by the time they got to our house. And so it took a little bit for us to figure out that that's what was happening. We could hear something, but we didn't know what was going on. But the carolers came especially for him, too.
Yeah. Caroling was always a big part of Christmas when we were younger, and it was fun to be a caroler or just have them come maybe to your grandpa and grandma's house or whatever. So we have our caroler today, and we can join Richard, but he's going to sing in German. He's going to sing Silent Night in German and maybe some other things. We're going to kind of let him enjoy doing some German memories.
Yeah, okay. Okay. Yeah, you know, the thing that really I'll never forget. Well, you know where I was, where I lived. Well, I'm sure did. And anyway, my mother would take me to Timothy in the morning. And she would say, I guess I was chattering or something. She says, what did back my deal? And then she always would sing the same old song that was one of her favorite songs. And all kidding aside, when the Germans were here the last time, they still sing that in their church. Is Jesu Geforan. Jesu geh voran auf der Lebensbahn und ne weilen nicht der weilen dir getreulich nachzuweilen führens an der Hand the best ins Vaters Land. Do you know what I sang?
No.
Jesus goes ahead of us. No? Okay. Jesus goes ahead of us.
Oh, okay.
Auf der Lebensbahn. Even in your work, God will help you through the day. Oh my goodness sakes, now I'm blank. That don't happen to a younger man. No, but anyway, that's the main drift of it. Okay, and you know, a lot of people came here from Ostfriesland area, and you know what the. What their song is, the old Frieslands? Any of you? In Ostfriesland ist'n besten, over Friesland kite the nicks. Wo de Witte Denny, de bin so moya, and de Jungs, de bin so fix. Over Friesland kite the nicks. On the snoggins, magic vasen. That's their song, the journey in that area. And I'm sure, have you, as anyone, you know this, Santa Claus to Santa Claus, Brennan meets your sucker goat, night to fill and night to men, smeet meet month to scuffs and in.
So what is it?
You don't know what that is either?
Santa Claus,
you Santa Claus, bring me some sugar goods. Not too much and not too little. Just throw it down my chimney. Oh. Yeah, had another one. Nu dank bin aan God met mond en hand, de groot dit und legen. Yeah, I think I'll forget that.
Can you do the silent night for us?
Yes, sir. Man. Yes, I can. Okay. And after I'm done with it, you play it right away. And after I'm done with it, we're going to sing the first verse. Okay?
In English.
But you can sing with me if you like. Okay, go ahead, Marcia.
Stille Nacht, heilige Nacht, alle schlief, einsam wacht, nur das heilige Elternpaar, das in Stall zu Bethlehem war, schlaf.
Thank you.
to, you know, picture some of our ancestors sitting around the graph in a circle listening to that, something new. Is that good? Or you want to play another one?
Yes, up to you.
We can hear another one.
One I'll be playing with by the Edison Carol Singers, and it's Joy to the World.
What year is the phonograph?
The phonograph is a 1915.
1915, yeah. 1915, yeah. 1-5. I knew it wasn't from the 50s because I had one.
We remember those days, don't we?
I've collected these type of Christmas songs for probably 50 years, and it's hard to find Christmas on Edison. Victor, you can get all you want, but people, the farming communities, they didn't spend the money to only play it once a year. So,
true. How much would a farm family have to pay for a phonograph in those days?
After the 1914 Edison factory fire, they had all sorts of different ones before that. And then they just stopped it and synchronized it. You had three models to choose from. The Amarillo 30, which is this, a 50, which is the same with the double spring, and a 75, which is a floor model. And that's what they cost, $30, $50, and $75. And they ran that through 1929, and then it was it.
I imagine that was a lot for
That was a lot of money.
So we'll share some, we're going to do a little bit of singing, but before we do that, I'd like everybody to just comment on one thing that they remember their family doing that always brings Christmas memories back to them. Just Or if you want to do a favorite thing that you got from your parents, but what's one thing that your family has always done at Christmas time that you especially enjoy?
Homemade ice cream.
Christmas sets. Christmas at church. Christmas Eve. That's okay.
Put me on the spot here. I was thinking.
Okay, I'll come back.
a party when we put up the tree. We'd have all kinds of candy and music, and it was just almost better than Christmas morning.
Putting up the tree, absolutely.
Me?
Yes.
Okay. Well, I have a strange thing that came to my mind. People who know me know that I like my Christmas tree and my Christmas decorations. As I grew up, my mother would wait till just before Christmas to go to the grocery store in town, you know how that was, to get our tree, and it would be the one left over, and it would be scrawny. And that's what we would have. I don't know if that's why I am the way I am or what.
But it just wasn't quite the tree you had imagined. Joyce?
Well, I guess I remember when Frank was still alive. We lived in an apartment upstairs, and he went to get the Christmas tree. And when he came home, oh, what a tree. It was flat on one side. But you know, it fit pretty well. It wasn't so bad after all.
Decorating frosting cookies, cut out cookies.
That was fun, wasn't it? That was special.
Going around looking at Christmas lights everybody had set up.
Good, yep. Marcia?
Oh, my two oldest, my brother and sister, my oldest brother, I was only like 12 when they got married. So my mother would let me have one present on Christmas Eve to open, because we always had to wait until like New Year's to have Christmas. So I guess that's what I remember. Mom was kind to me.
Did you think, no?
You know, I think one of the things that I really thought of when we got an aluminum tree like that from Uncle Dick and Jeannie, and it had the rotating lights and everything. They had it in their shop, our big shop, for years. And then we got tired of it, I guess, so we got it. And I always thought that was so cool.
Okay, Richard?
Well, I tell you, this isn't over Christmas, but I will never forget going to your mom, and we had snow, and I went down there. It was around Christmas time, and I had an old tractor and no heehouser or nothing on it, you know, colder than cold. And then she said, "You got to come in and have some speckin' dickin'."
Oh, sure.
And I mean, she did that all day long, didn't she? I'll never forget it. And I came home and Mom says, "You want something to eat?" I said, "Oh, I know." But that was a treat. And your mother was good at that.
Always hospitable, right?
Well, I remember basically Christmas Eve, because it was always going to the church Christmas program. I could never figure out why we were always in the car, and then my mom would have to go back to the house, you know. And then when we got home, Santa Claus had been there. And also, I remember Christmas nights, because for my maiden name was Reuter, and for 85 consecutive years, we had the Reuter Christmas on Christmas night. It used to be at Ike and Alice's house on the farm, and all the Reuters and all the grandchildren would crowd into the living room, kind of like this. And so that was special. As far as the one year Alice actually put candles on the tree. Yeah. Like, people were sitting this close to the candles, and they were all in one room. So that was kind of, but the tradition that everybody brought the same treats on Christmas night.
Yeah.
And just this past July 31st, the cousins, the Reuter cousins, had a Christmas in July, and we had it at the community building and reenacted a Reuter Christmas.
Fun. That's fun.
I remember after the Christmas program at church, we would always get this sack. It had peanuts and nuts and apples and oranges and some candy bars in it.
Which we didn't get very often.
Didn't get very often, so we're excited about getting the sack.
Yep.
Going caroling.
Yeah.
I remember going to around to our aunts and uncles' houses, and we all sat on the sofa like little angels. You know, we never moved. We didn't get up to go to the bathroom.
Your best behavior on Christmas, yeah. Just in case, right?
The Christmas programs.
We were in the same church. I remember one year when I had a can-can that was so, remember when they were next to your wore that under your Christmas dresses? Couldn't even sit down.
I guess I just had the same as meeting, that we would be sit in the car and we never knew why Mom took so long to come. It took me years to figure that out.
But at least Santa was, and then Santa came after
when
Christmas
we would come home, then Santa would have been there because she put everything up.
So. Yeah. Richard?
Well, I can remember we had to go to church and stuff. Everybody had on their best clothes on.
Best clothes. Dressed up always, yeah.
A lot of them are repetition from before, but I guess the same year too. When we went to church and came home, there were presents.
It's interesting. I was talking about everybody pretty much remembering going to church is a major part of their Christmas. That's probably unique to this community a little bit.
Oh my.
We just kind of finished that program.
From Arlington.
Oh, okay.
Do you rather have them come in the other door?
Yeah,
why don't you come in the other door?
And then otherwise, someone can have my seat.
We need the ramp.
Okay, that's fine then.
You're going to have to let them come through here.
Yeah, that's fine. All right, well, that's great.
And we'll, right there. Have a seat.
Well, let's go through it really quick, and then we'll sing carols.
We all came in the same group. Yeah. And by the time we put that, there was no extra room whatsoever.
That even went to my kids.
Yeah.
Well, my grandparents came over just before World War I, and I just remember.
Yep.
You know, the food that we had, rye bread, caraway seed cheese, and speck and dinkin, and it was good.
Yes.
And haven't had that good since.
Well, I did not grow up in this community, but we had many of the same traditions. It sounds like Christmas Eve program at church and saps afterwards, and Mom taking so long to get to the car.
And that's mine too, the church service. And I always remember we had to order our sacks, ahead.
Yes,
we'd pay for them. Us kids would be so embarrassed because they'd say, Brant for eight, because we were six kids. So us kids were all embarrassed, but it was always such a pleasant thing.
Oh, hi. That's good. Thank you.
Because they had homemade ice cream. Had to go down the creek and get the ice and bring it up. And
oh, right. Going down to the creek?
Ham sandwiches, always ham sandwiches.
Oh, you ice cream from the creek.
And later on, I got kids and Charlie. He was a kid.
I remember he was just like Joyce said.
Oh, yeah.
I can remember there, you can imagine there was 10 of us kids, putting up the tree.
Okay,
all
right, come on over and sit.
Come on in.
Okay, we'll go back in that next row.
Find a spot. And we'll just sing a few carols together while they're coming.
You must have neck surgery too. I've been having shots. I got a spot. There won't be surgery. Die or paralyzed. Maybe it's a good thing.
Just join the girls together.
Just go.
We'll come on, you faithful.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, are you guys all right?
Is there anybody else coming in, do you think? We got everybody? Okay. Great.
We got
we'll
four.
Get you some treats in a little bit.
We have about four six. More. Nancy.
Okay, four more.
Thank you.
some photograph music. From all over the world and from around here. But let's have Richard Schafer sing, and we'll use our pump organ from the 1900s, and we'll do a German song. You see if you can tell what it is.
Oh, ja, da weißt du wohl.
You ready?
Okay.
We'll sing the first verse of that.
What'd you want from Santa? Is that what he...
No, old candy. or art something, you know, yeah. And then throw it down the chimney. Yeah.
Did you have another song that was you sang before? The one about the Ostfriesland?
Oh, and this is still very popular there. Yeah, because when they would come here, you know, in Wellsburg, they would sing this, definitely. In Ostfriesland ist'n Bassen, over Friesland kite the nix. Vor de Wächter, de bin so moya, de Jungs, de bin so fix. In Ostfriesland mag ich weisen, anders nagens mag ich weisen.
Well, you had a few people understand and laugh. Yes. So, I mean, that was good.
Yes, there's a few.
And then I could just well sing the other one too. Yeah. My mother, when she took me to school, and then she would, I don't know if I chattered or what, but anyway, she told me, what did Batman do? Shut up. And then she would get me to sing, Jesu, hey, foran. Auf der Lebensbahn, und der Weilen, erst der Weilen, dir geht treulich nach zu eilen, für uns an der Hand, bist ins Vaters Land, bist ins Vaters, you're in God's land. Okay. Oh.
Nice.
A few things I remember. So I used to be able to sing the Lord's Prayer.
Yeah. Oh,
yeah, but Alighton helped me with that. He was good at it.
What we were doing with the other group, and if anybody's from the other group that needs to leave, just get up and go. But we were saying Christmas is a time that we all have memories coming back to us, just flooding with some of the wonderful times we either had with our parents. So we just shared a good memory that we had of Christmas and what made it special to us. Burdette, what's Christmas to you?
Well, I remember one time we were sitting at the table, Mom and Dad and Grandma Kaiser, and they shifted to German. And I was there, okay. Well, the Dad had been to Bevings and Flessner in town at Bevings Hardware, and he bought a new three-speed Schwinn bike for me. I really wanted a blue one, but I was getting a red one because they chattered everything. I understood all of it. That kind of let the cat out of the bag, but anyway.
So his parents were talking German. They thought he wouldn't get it. He did.
Do you still have your bike?
What?
Do you still have that bike?
You bet I do. I got it out of the attic a couple years ago, and I thought, I can do this. We got about 2 feet, and I decided to run it back up to the attic.
So you will.
And it worked so good.
Yeah.
Did you get to tell us what your favorite memory was?
Well, we always went to my grandparents, and we all had to be in the same room.
Yeah.
We had a gift exchange. And all of the kids, the grandkids and then the great-grandkids, had to go up to my grandfather, and he would give them $1. And that was the most important gift that any of those kids got.
$1. Sometimes it was a silver dollar?
No, it was a regular dollar.
Regular dollar, yeah. Do you have a favorite what is your name?
Emma.
Emma, do you have a favorite memory from your young life?
I think I was about 12, and my parents, we hadn't had a dog in a long time, and they knew I wanted one, and I opened up this box of Chex cereal, and my mom, then I opened up a kennel, and I was like, what is this? And she's like, those are treats for your new puppy. We're going to go get a puppy. So that was one of my favorite memories of that too.
Yeah, that's good.
I remember when we were small, we would go to my grandmother's house on Christmas Eve. She always had chili and oyster soups. But walking into the house, and she had buns and cookies, oatmeal cookies. And
I can still taste those, can't you?
Smell them too.
Yeah. Do you have a favorite memory?
Do you have a favorite Christmas memory?
My grandmother, we didn't see very often. She lived in Illinois. She made dolls out of stockings. And so one year for Christmas, I got a doll and my brother got a lamb. And it was wrapped in a soda cracker box. And I said, "Oh, Larry. Grandma sent you crackers." He was so down about that until he opened it and found Whammy in there. And Whammy might be a bigger favorite toy.
What do you have?
My dad was in the insurance business, and I knew when he started going down to the basement, that was going to be a special project. Here it was a little table and wooden chairs and
he made
board
it.
One winter.
Oh, he made it himself. Wonderful. What do you remember?
Well, my bed was right under where the chimney would come down if there was a fireplace in the house. And I remember worrying what was going to happen when Santa hit that spot.
Chimney and no fire.
Brian, do you have a special Christmas memory?
No.
Okay. Right. You just enjoy.
Do you have a favorite Christmas memory?
Yeah.
Do you want to share it?
Yeah.
Okay, you go ahead.
Well, it was Christmas time and we had little kids. And I wanted a pony for Christmas. So we lived in town.
Did you get the pony?
It wasn't what you had in mind, was it?
No more Ross?
No memory that you want to share?
Okay. We just all anticipated Christmas.
Yes.
Did your family all live close so nobody had to come home from a ways? They were all here?
Well, yeah, our immediate family, yes, yeah. We didn't have to celebrate Christmas like that. I mean, we celebrated, but not with gatherings.
Okay, yeah. Everybody has their own style.
Yes.
Yeah. Barbara, do you remember?
Remember?
That's okay. Well, we're glad you're here to celebrate with us, for sure. Okay.
Mary, can I share a memory of my mother?
Yes.
My mom was in a, there were three little girls in her family. I mean, she was one of three. And they were very poor. And so her parents told her about a week before Christmas, there won't be any tree, there won't be any presents this year. They just couldn't afford it. And a neighbor got word of that. And they went to bed on Christmas Eve, and when they woke up in the morning, a neighbor had brought in a tree with three little dolls underneath.
Oh.
So they were just sweet little.
We had just read a poem earlier about an old-fashioned Christmas, how it's not all the things that you get, but it's giving and spending time with friends and that sort of thing. And that's why we're so glad that you're here today, to just enjoy some cookies and some refreshments. And maybe we'll hear, unless you have something, we'll hear another recording from the phonograph. And feel free to walk around or look around.
Did you share? No?
I don't have it.
Okay, that's fine.
Or would you like to hear something on the pump organ? Maybe let's do Silent Lamb. Oh, come all you faithful. Cookies or drinks.